Hello dear friends, today we present you our first ever lesson on PHP tagging. Our designer Kate will create a tag in Adobe Photoshop. You can find all the items she's using listed in the description box under the video. Please accept our deepest apologies for any language mistakes our team makes in such tutorials, as English is not our native language. We are working to improve. We would like to also remind you to always put artist copyright on your tags. We will show how to do it in our later videos. Hope this will be of great help for you. Let's get started! Kate has already downloaded the tube from Artist Whale. The document has several layers, so the first thing she's going to do is adjusting the picture to her liking. For example, changing the color of hair, dress or accessories. She's going to delete the layers she doesn't need and turn on and off ones that are useful for her. To put it simply, first you need to play around with the layers to decide on final look of the tube. Now pressing the Ctrl key, she's clicking the layer she decided to use with the left mouse button. Then she presses any of selected layers with the right mouse button and chooses to group the layers. She names this group. After that, she presses the highest layer of the group while pressing the Shift key. She selects all the layers and deletes them, as she doesn't need them anymore. Then she clicks the grouped layers folder with the right mouse button and chooses to unite the layers. This way she gets the desired picture. Kate changes the size of her canvas pressing F7 on her keyboard. Then she presses Enter. She relocates the picture of the girl. After that, she starts adding the elements of the scrap kit to the canvas. She adds the beach element and moves it to the back burner. Now Kate needs to create a background on the canvas. She creates a new layer for this. She selects it and chooses the instrument gradient. You can choose the color for gradient in the settings. Once again, she moves the layer to the back burner just by relocating it in the list. She adds more elements of the scrap kit. Kate puts dolphins to the back burner higher than the background layer. She advises to lock the background layer so it won't move when you relocate other elements. Kate makes a copy of Sand Scrap element by using Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V keys combination. She uses it twice. As to the birds, Kate put them to the back burner but higher than the background layer. To achieve the same effect, click the element with the right mouse button and choose to mirror it horizontally. That's all for today, hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to leave feedback. Please suggest us new ideas for tutorials in the comments. See you on Friday!